the strategic plan, which was presented before the various stakeholders in Hoima City, runs up to 2040. The plan will be implemented by 26 districts, including Hoima, Nuoya, Kiriadongo, Bulisa, Mpiji, Wakiso, Masindi, Kiwoga, Mubende, Chankwansi, Chikube, Nakasongola, among others. According to Dr. Emmanuel Brian Guma, the team leader of the Albertine Water Management Zone in the Ministry of Water and Environment, the main aim of this plan is to ensure that they protect the catchment areas of the wetlands, restore the degraded areas, and also end water pollution.
Pressure on the water resources. So people are actually moving to the pristine ecosystems, the catchment areas, degrading them, looking for water, looking for fertile soils. And it is through this that we came up with a novel approach, that is the catchment-based water resources management, where we involve all the different stakeholders from the bottom in the management of water resources. So it has been a strategic and novel solution in having everyone fully involved in protecting water resources.
Dr. Guma adds that the environment has been greatly affected by the rapid population growth and climate change.
Year in, year out, the pressures are actually getting enormous, and this has been exacerbated by the climate change. Climate change is quite real. We're having shorter and heavier rains, and also longer, drier spells. So this is actually exacerbating the whole situation in terms of water security, and through this novel approach of catchment-based, we are trying to reverse the block.
He further highlights the lack of enough funds as one of the main reasons as why their efforts have been frustrated. He also thinks partnerships could help solve the problem.
We want to encourage partnerships. As government, we should encourage partnerships, and it's also one of the sustainable development goals, where you cannot work alone. You have to encourage partnerships across everyone so that we move the agenda forward.
Political leaders have been requested to join hands in order to protect the catchment areas in the country as a way of saving the environment.
Before I give that, one problem is that there is what we call selective prosecution in Uganda. You find wetland in Kampala are being constructed. You find wetland in Wakisu, there is construction going on. You find wetland in Gulu City, there is construction going on. But you find wetland in villages where there are the poor minority Ugandans who cannot earn 1,000 shillings per day. They are being deprived of not using this wetland. For us, as country, to do the right thing is that we should not have selective prosecution.
There is where areas where people have been growing rice in wetlands, we go to those people, arrested them, and the cover has gone back. It has gone back to its original form. And those who are even growing, who are even cutting charcoal, we are ensuring that we don't give them a chance. Now, for example, there is a place in River Wambabia down here. In the River Wambabia is this river which goes down and produces electricity down in Seruka. There is somebody who has claimed that he's going to take me to court together with the whole security team.
This story has been compiled by Godfrey Muhumuza for the news.